people, whether Japanese or Tibetan or Chinese or Thai or whoever, and also I think some other tradition also, like Christian or Hindus or Jains or Muslim, they, without knowing the meaning of the text, scripture, but the mere recite, not much useful, not much sort of effective. But of course, you see, recitation carried by a genuine sort of faith or respect, as a Buddhist, respect to Buddha, and then, although not knowing the meaning, just recite that, you may have some sort of merit, but that's not sufficient. So therefore, I always believe, and also sharing with the other people, the knowing at least the essence of one's own tradition is very, very essential. So for that, as far as Buddhism is concerned, especially according to the Tibetan tradition, we consider study is very, very important, very essential, very necessary. Not much value, just writing or recite, but that does not mean no value, no benefit at all, not that way. But at least you have some interest about that sutra, and some cases recite, some cases just writing, then I think not live on that level. Try to learn. Now, for example, my own case, when I first start to learn by heart some of these root texts, including the Heart Sutra, then suddenly I do not understand what the meaning. When I recite almost like a different language, but then eventually, you see, learned by word, so that's the way. So therefore, reciting sutra, Heart Sutra, and also the copying, that will helpful to remind you, or to keep in your mind some kind of closeness to the Heart Sutra. So that may help to develop more enthusiasm to study. Not only just you see a letter which have different interpretation, but even the just meaning of emptiness, or selflessness. You see that within Buddhist school of thought, there is a different meaning. Not only just a different interpretation, but I think different meaning. Even if Buddha when Buddha taught teaching to his follower, at different time, different place, different audience, you see, Buddha deliberately, explained different meaning of emptiness or the selflessness. Use same word. So therefore, in our tradition, especially now, look, according the commentary of like Heart Sutra, written by great masters of Nalanda, Nalanda University, like Nagarjuna, Nagarjuna's commentary regarding the Prajaparamita Sutra, and the commentary written by Arya Sangha. Differences. There is the differences. Then within the Nagarjuna's own sort of senior student, Baba Viveka, his sort of explanation and the Buddha Palita, same sort of text to make comment, and same teacher, Nagarjuna, but you see the interpretation between these two senior students of Nagarjuna is a big differences. So therefore, it is very very important, you see, to study commentary of these sutra by different Indian masters. I think that's very important. In our tradition, in Tibetan tradition, you see, usually, you see, according this sort of, what say they, master, like for example, according the Buddha Palita, the interpretation of emptiness is like this. Then, according Arya Sangha, the interpretation of emptiness is like this. So we usually, you see, make clear the differences according to different interpretation of different masters. So therefore, there is always, you see, danger, you see, to get wrong sort of interpretation. Not only just, you see, interpretation due to the letter, but the real meaning itself, you see, there is big differences. So therefore, in order to know, you see, Buddha's sort of teaching, as now in the field of, what's it, theory, there are many different sort of concepts. So therefore, the study is very, very essential. And some kind of, as a comparative study within the interpretation of different masters of Nalanda tradition. Although I have no sort of clear information of what, how many commentary on Heart Sutra by some ancient, some past Japanese scholars or masters, I don't know. And also I don't know in the Chinese language. I think there must be. But in any case, the if there are some commentary on these like Heart Sutra, then study and make comparison. Teyatha gadi gadi paragadi parasangadi buddhisa. I believe, you see, there are different interpretation or different meaning according to different, I think, different practice. That means sutrayana and tantrayana. But according one author, writer of commentary of the Heart Sutra, you see, that master, as a translate, you see, mantra, they're like gadi gadi go go, gadi gadi para gadi go beyond, then para sangadi go thoroughly beyond. That meaning, usually, you see, they are according Buddha's teaching, according the progress of inner spiritual experiences. In order to know easier, you see, Buddha makes five different stages. Different stages. So, the first stage, from our present sort of level, go this stage. Then further go this stage. Then go beyond means, now the third stage, now the understanding of the shunya or emptiness, which is the explaining in the Heart Sutra. You see, that emptiness now directly perceived at this level. So therefore it mentioned go beyond. Then further develop. Now further develop in the fourth stage. That means the not only seeing the perceived directly emptiness perceived directly, but also getting acquainted, much acquainted, so that go thoroughly beyond means, you see, the further acquaintance. So get used to it. And as a result, then finally the ignorance, the seed of samsara, seed of suffering, then completely eliminated from our mind, because the wisdom of understanding of the shunya as a wisdom, that now completely developed. So go thoroughly beyond. So from that, then next stage, now usually we call moksha or nirvana, salvation. Now all the ignorance completely sort of removed or eliminated. So that's the stage of nirvana. So now you already enlightened, because you see, the ignorance or afflictory emotion no longer in our mind. So that mind then becomes something perfect or enlightened. So that's the fifth stage. So that's the different stages of the inner spiritual development. So now here, the first go, that means not necessarily seeing, understanding shunya. The second stage, then without realization of shunya, you cannot go second stage. So the second stage, one quality, the person, the practitioner, as soon as develop the inner spiritual experiences of the some kind of union, the vipassana and the samadhi, on focusing shunya, then you reach this one. But still, at that time, not perceiving directly. So further sort of practice, familiarize. Then, as soon as this combination, samadhi and vipassana, combine and focusing on shunya or emptiness, then perceived directly. As soon as you get that sort of experience, then you reach third stage. Call it that. So therefore, the meaning of tayatha means something as follows. In this way. Tayatha means in this way. Then what way? Go beyond. Go thoroughly beyond. And establish yourself enlightened. So the Heart Sutra at the beginning, something like form is empty. Empty is form. They are mainly explaining about the meaning of emptiness. and according to truth, ultimate truth. Then, after that explanation, this mainly Shishunya, according to truth. Then the mantra explaining as a result of understanding, as a result of understanding Shunya and how transformation will take place. That explanation carried by the mantra. Gat, Dhyatha, Gat, Gat, Paragat, Parasam, Upadesham, like that. So in other words, the rest of this sutra explaining the subject to be meditated. Then, as a result of meditate on Shunya, what transformation will take place? That mentioned Dhyatha, Gat, Gat, Paragat, Parasam, Upadesham. And also, I think there is the something like the examine what one's own sort of mental stage or spiritual stage is. Now, for example, I can, although my knowledge is very limited about these as a subject, still I can explain. And also, when I think, when I meditate about Shunya, some understanding, some feeling there as a result of, I think, the effort of many decades, now at least 4 or 5 decades now. But then, if I feel, oh, now I have some understanding about Shunya, or I may be very highly developed, then when I think, or when I sort of go through Dhyatha, Gati, Gati, Paragati, Parasamudhisa, then I know, oh, my level, my spiritual level is very, very low. So that's important. So sometimes when we get little knowledge, we feel, oh, I have a lot of knowledge or a very high spiritual realization. That's sometimes it's dangerous. So therefore, it is very useful, helpful, you see, to have one method, you see, to examine one's spiritual level. A method or way to examine one's own spiritual level. So long, you see, my understanding about Shunya without direct perception, direct realization, that means I have no sign or no hope, I have no base to claim I reach this stage. Then, say, the samadhi, I know I have no samadhi, not yet developed. So then, you know, oh, I also is not reached this third stage. Because in order to, the qualification of this third stage, experience of combination, samadhi and vipassana, which focusing on Shunya. So, since I have no samadhi experience, so therefore, you see, it is very clear, I still not yet reached here. So, only hope is, oh, begin to reach somewhere here. If I put more effort and certainly, you see, more time, then some hope to reach this stage like that. There's another sutra mentioned, Tathagata Garva or Sukata Shindaya, the seed of Buddha, Buddha nature, we call Buddha nature. Tathagata Garva Sutra or Sukata Shindaya, Sukata Shindaya Sutra, which is mentioned, or the, which is that sutra, what's it, I think, main subject of that sutra is the seed of Buddha. So when we study, when we think about the very nature of mind, the some kind of pureness is there. So that, roughly speaking, you see, one one of the Tathagata, Shindaya, Sugata Shindaya. So one of the seed of Buddha, the part, aspect of the pureness of ultimate nature of mind. So that's, we believe, the every mind, or every being, every sentient being, the ultimate nature of the mind is pure. So all the afflicted emotions, essentially, can be separable from the mind if other forces, opposite forces, come. So now here, all the afflicted emotion come from ignorance. Now there are a lot of different ignorance, but here the ignorance which wrongly perceived, because wrongly perceived or wrongly grasped the reality. So that's the main ignorance. So that misconception and the realization of reality is just opposite one another. Just like, almost like dark and light. As soon as light comes, dark will go. So similarly, as soon as you develop the realization of the ultimate reality, that means shunya, then the misconception of reality is false, will reduce. Then eventually, when the realization of reality fully develop, the full through experience fully develop, then the all the misconceptions will completely disappear. So that's the Buddhist explanation why there is Buddha seed. And because of that, every sentient being have potential to become Buddha. So that's Buddhist explanation. So it is useful to study these two sutras, Heart Sutra or Prajaparamita Sutra, other is the Panchaparamita Sutra, which is somewhat more elaborate. So that sutra and sutra of Sukata Shindaya. So combine these two things are very useful. Essence, or in few words, the shunya, Sanskrit, the emptiness. In order to know emptiness or empty, now for example, Now in this place, no elephant here. So non-existence of elephant is here. We can understand, we can know, we can feel non-existence of elephant. Now in order to know non-existence of elephant, firstly, at least in mentally, you should have some idea what is elephant. Knowing that, then non-existence of elephant, then you can develop. Someone who have no idea at all about elephant, then in his or her mind, the non-existence of elephant still something unclear. So similarly, empty means absence of independent existence. The real meaning is not nothingness. Here is it a Nagarjuna, and particularly the Puttaparita, made very clear. The empty means interdependent. So that means empty is not nothingness. Because empty means ultimately interdependence, interdependent. So interdependent means there is something. Something exists. So its quality is interdependent. So anything which interdependent is something fact, something existence. Therefore, the Nagarjuna, as well as the Buddhapalita and also the Chandragiti, they explain the emptiness means something interdependent. Interdependent means there is no independent absolute. So now, the absence of independence, that's Shunya. Now, why there is absence of independence? Means, yes, things are interdependent. How? Why? Or how? How? I think how? If things are exist independently or absolutely, then when we carry investigation, the nature of the existence, the things should be clear. Now, for example, like the paper, when we certainly if we call this paper, yes, it is true. We can write on it. We can use. So it is fact. Everybody knows. Even animals or flies, they may not know the word, but you see, they realize that there is something. So some fly, you see, can land on it. But when we investigate beyond the common sort of perception or common acceptance, yes, there's paper. Beyond that, when we investigate, what's the reality of the paper? Color, or the shape, or the substance, different particles, atom level, or even subatomic level, we can't find the essence of paper. So without investigate, we simply accept, yes, there is paper. But if we investigate, we can't find every phenomenon. Especially, I think, the concept of self, I. So I'm here, I'm Tibetan, I'm a Buddhist monk. Yes, nobody argue that. But if I investigate, where's my I? Whether I'm head, whether I'm heart, whether I'm leg, or here, or here. Or perhaps my eye is here, sometimes go there, that's not there. And also if I ask my mind, whether my mind is I or self, no. In that case, I cannot say properly my mind. So my mind, there's no sort of disagreement when we say my mind. So that means I is the owner, mind is the something like possession of the self. So therefore, we can express my mind, my thought. So that means essentially thought and self is two separate entity. But beside the body, beside the mind, we can't find self. So self is there, but if we investigate, we can't find, like paper. So then, that force to take conclusion that things are exist due to many other factors, not absolute or independently. So since we can't find, therefore, conclusion is things are there, but we cannot find. So therefore, you see, the nature of the existence must be interdependent, not independently. Therefore, because things exist by other factors, depend on other factor. So depend on other, not independent. Therefore, independent and dependent is direct opposite. There is no third alternative or possibility, either dependent or independent. So since independent through investigation, we can't find, therefore conclusion, it exists, it works, at the same time cannot find, therefore the only sort of possibility is dependent. So since nature of the existence are dependent, so independent, impossible to there. So the very reality of the existence comes or happen only other factor. So therefore it is dependent nature. So dependent, independent, opposite each other, either independent or dependent. So things are dependent, therefore there is the absence of independent there. So the absence of independent. So that's shunya. That's empty of independency. So therefore the sutra mentioned form is empty. Form is there. So since you see form is exist, therefore there is no other way except empty. So therefore form is empty. Now, empty is form because the absence of independence, so dependence possible. So dependence things, dependence there, so other factor can work and solve causes in the conditions, then can be effective. If things independent, then causes, conditions, no relevant, no role. So therefore, since absence of independence there, therefore causes, conditions then become reality, become factor. Therefore, empty is form. So here is a Buddhist, according to Buddhist tradition, two kind of meditation. One, single-pointed meditation, without investigate. Now, for example, when we meditate on our mind, just think about mind, without investigate. Or meditate on Buddha statue or Buddha, not the statue, but the reflection of the Buddha statue in our mind, some picture of Buddha there. Now your mind concentrate on that. So that's single-pointed meditation. Then another, now for example, Buddha, yes. Now you, in your mind, Buddha there. Now investigate, what is Buddha? Whether his body, whether his enlightened mind, we cannot find. Just the same, just like ourselves. Without investigate, yes, there is self, there is I. There's one person here. But investigate, we cannot find. Similarly, Buddha. Without investigate, yes, there is Shakyamuni Buddha. Our teacher, our master. But if we investigate, we can't find Buddha. So that's the emptiness of Buddha. The emptiness itself also, if we further investigate, what is the emptiness? Again, we can't find. So that's the heart, the Prajapalamita Sutra said, the emptiness of emptiness. So there are two emptiness, further four emptiness, then 16 emptiness, then 18 emptiness, then 20 emptiness, like that. So here, the shunya itself also, when we further sort of divided or divisions make, then the emptiness of emptiness, also one of them. So all phenomena, including Buddha, including emptiness itself, everything are nothingness. But yes, this is fact. We get pains, we get pleasure, we get sorrow, I think this and that.
Jagarakati Bhagavati Panja Paramatarsindaya Pukiti Tutin Tima Shiruji Paruti Chibi Nimbo Kumbo Shukuntaki Daki Tubati Dina Tutin Ti Jabu Chaku Kumbo Rangaki Mungi Gindi Chambo Tan Tantu Sabi Gindi Chambo Tan Tawa Tiki Ji Ti Ti Tutin Ti Tamo Numa Ji Jabu Chuyo Mungo Ji Tengi Dala Jumbo Ji Kuru Ya Ji Ti Tantu Sabi Baba Jiri Zong Chi Shiro Ji Paru Di Chumba Kamu Kyo Pani La Nambar Ta Jang Kumbu Nga Bo Ti Tang La Yang Rong Sing Ji Kumbu Nambar Ta Wu Jani San Ji Jin Ti Ti Tang Dambar Shari Bu Tang Ti So Ba So Ba Chang Bu Baba Jiri Zong Chi Lang Ti Ki Chi Mi Su Ri Ji Bu Yung Ga La Shiro Ji Paru Di Chumba Kamu Kya Par Kya Pan Tu Ba Ti Chi Ta La Par Cha Ti Ki Chi Mi Ba Tung Tung Tu So Ba So Ba Chang Bu Baba Jiri Zong Chi Ki 제동담바샤리발란드샤리다드발란드게제메소샤리부르기포르기포모 동바고 샤리브 데더 주 탐지 동바니 티 체니메 바 마키바 망가바 아트마메 바 트마도 타와 조메 바 고메 바 고 샤리브 데더 나 동바니 아지메 토메 디시메 디지메 마바리 시바메 니메 나와미 나미 키메 니메 이메 디메 다메 키메 로메 아라자메 키메 도메 카메 파리 키 카메 Maribame, Mariba, Sabame, Bani, Kashimi, Kashi, Sabi, Pati, Lamitu, Tim Shinze, Timawa, Tuma, Kumbobata, Lami, Ishimi, Topame, Matopaya, Mitu, Sharibe, Tatame, Tantu, Saw, Tantu, Sabana, Topame, Shiroji, Paru, Sambala, Tinta, Niti, Samla, Tabame, Tabame, Chinji, Loli, Shinji, Dini, Nimala, Dipin, Tarim, Shinji, Sunda, Namaji, Tante, Tante, Shiroji, Paru, Lana me bayan dong ba tu bi chan chu dong ba tu ba tong chi su tu da me na chi ru chi ta ru chu chi bi ma ru ba chi bu ma lana me bi ma me ni ba na ni bi ma ni ma tham chi ru chi chu ru chi bi ma me ra ni ma tham chi ru chi chu ru chi bi ma me tu ba ru chi ba ru chi ba cha chi chi ru chi ba ru chi chi bi ma me ba ta ya ta ga ten ga ti pa ran ga ti pa ra san ga ti gu ti so Shayipu Tante Sapa Sapa Chimbu Teta Shiroji Paru Tu Chimbu Tamula Labra Chak Tini Tu Tinti Tingi Ti Tili Tante Tante Sapa Sapa Chimbu Paba Chiri Su Yung Chila Lisu Jita Apsini Lisu Lisu Rijipu Titi Vishinno Rijipu Titi Vishinti Chetra Chuchi Timba Chinti Shiroji Paru Tu Chimbu Tamula Chabra Chati Tivi Sapa Nati Titi Yeramu Chuchi Titi Tiki Jika Tan Chetan Chamba Chari Tati Bhuti Chamsi Sopa Sopa Chambung Thoba Chiri Dung Chitong Chamsi Tang Tembe Kuru Tepa Tatam Tung Hamba Yendo Chitra Chibi Chiti Yirant Chiti Chichi Tungpa Lama Mbratu Tung Taya Tang Gati Gati Paran Gati Paran Singa Timbuti Suwa Taya Tang Gati Gati Paran Gati Paran Singa Timbuti Suwa Taya Tang Gati Gati Paran Gati Paran Singa Timbuti Suwa Namu Lama Chang Taro Chamsi La Chang Chang
These days, not only Japanese people, but also I think many of the nations, sometimes even people use the word whole world, now is facing certain sort of instability and problems, and then including economy problems. So therefore, not only Japanese, so you are not lonely. You have many companions. So now question is whether we humanity, whether world are going to be doomed or not. I don't think. We humanity. I think in the past, several thousands, several centuries, we are here. Suddenly, in human history, always some problems, always there, some disasters, always there, but we survived. But now today, except I think the nuclear holocaust, then I think if some mad people create some kind of the nuclear holocaust, then I think something really different. Otherwise, through some problems, some tragedies, humanity will survive. And not only survive, but I have some reasons to believe that this century, 21st century, going to be more peaceful, more harmonious, more friendly. This is my feeling, my hope. Because from 20th century, we humanity learned, or I think we humanity carried a lot of different experiment. I think including warfare. So finally, I think even the later part of the 20th century, I think humanity becoming more mature. The sign of more maturity is talking seriously about non-violence and taking seriously about taking care of the environment or the planet itself. And talking the human rights, ecology, and freedom, democracy. I think these are the sign of maturity, right? Maturity of human being, maturity. So therefore, now I think one example, I think including Japanese, among the people, I think the desire of peace, or desire of, free of nuclear weapon, I think these are everywhere now growing. And also the desire or concern, serious concern about environment. These are now really rapidly increasing, developing. Then concept of ahimsa, concept of non-violence, also growing, gaining strength. So therefore, if we human being use human intelligence properly with help of warm heart and wider vision, then I feel there is every reason to hope, to be hopeful about humanity in future. At least next few centuries, I think, will be go like that. And after 1,000 years, I don't know. too long. It is very important to keep determination and self-confidence. It's a combined human intelligence and warm heart, good heart must combine. If you gain some sort of experience out of deeper understanding and familiarization of the concept of emptiness, concept of interdependency, certainly our view, our attitude widened. As a result, in daily life, when we come across some problems, because our attitude now widened, we always, you see, look the holistic picture. So, as a result, disturbances in our emotion level, much less. Otherwise, our mind too much sort of narrow. Then, small factor can disturb your mind. So, some experience about the shunya, about relative, or about interdependency. Well, it is very useful, helpful. Then plus, the one, I think, key message of Buddha, key sort of practice, the key practice of Buddha Dharma is a practice of compassion, practice of karuna, infinite altruism. So, combine altruism, infinite altruism, and realization of shunya, useful.